Lab number four deals with physical and chemical changes. You've encountered these terms within the text. A physical change is one in which there's no change in composition. A chemical change does. Yes, there's a change in composition. Have something new, something that we didn't have before. A lot of times we talk about these as reactions. Starting material and then a product, something new over there. An example of this might be if we had a piece of paper, and if I crumpled up the piece of paper, certainly there's been a process take place, a change, but there was no change in composition. I had paper when I started, and we've got paper when I finished. It looks a little different, but it's still paper. But if I were to touch a match to the paper and the paper burns, well, then we see something new. We see a gas given off. We see a black residue that we didn't have before. That would be an example of a chemical change. In general, the observations that we use in chemistry to decide whether a chemical process has taken place are these three. If there's a color change, oftentimes that indicates that we've got something new. Formation of a solid, when we didn't have a solid to begin with, we call that a precipitate. A precipitate can be more dense, it can settle to the bottom of a test tube, or it could float, or sometimes it just introduces a general cloudiness into the solution. And then the third way we tell whether a chemical process has taken place is if a gas forms. Didn't have a gas when we started, but now we see bubbles given off, and so that would indicate a chemical change. Let's look at the processes that we'll use in this experiment. There are five processes that you'll investigate: solution formation, heating copper carbonate, and so on. And then in the culmination of the experiment, in table 4.11, you'll decide if each of these five processes is a physical change or a chemical change. And the way you'll do that is to look at the material that you're starting with. Let's say that we're starting with A, and we're undergoing one of these five processes now, solution formation, we'll say. And over here, we'll look at the material afterwards. Well, if we start with A and we decide that this is A over here, there's been no change in composition. So we would conclude that that particular process is a physical one. If we start with A and it looks like we've got B when we end up, then we'd say, well, yes, there has been a change in composition. It's a chemical change. And the way we decide that is to look at the properties of this material that we start with and compare those with the properties that we end up with, properties of the material that we end up with. And we perform several tests, and the same tests over here on these two materials. And we don't care whether these are physical or chemical tests. Most of them are chemical, reaction with silver nitrate or whatever the test may be. It's this process right here that we're trying to decide, is it physical or chemical? So again, don't let these tests confuse you. Most of them are chemical tests, but we're simply trying to decide whether the material we have is A or B. Let's look at another board. In part A of the experiment, you're looking at solution formation, and you'll have the original solid, A, and over here is the recovered solid, and you'll be trying to decide if it's A or B. And here are the two tests now that you'll perform on both the original and the recovered. You'll look at flame color. And for the sake of a little experience, let's say that the flame of this original solid, when we put the material into a flame, gives off an orange color. And when we do that with the recovered solid, it too gives off an orange color. When we add silver nitrate, let's just pretend that we get a cloudiness, or a precipitate, in other words. This material also gives a cloudiness or a precipitate. I don't care that this is a chemical test. That's not what we're up to. We're trying to decide if solution formation is a chemical or physical change. And in the next table, 4.2, we take this information and use it to answer the question, is there a composition change indicated? If these two materials gave the same result, we'd say, well, no, it looks like this material and this material gave the same result. There's no indication that a change in composition occurred. Same thing here. If this is the result that you get, same as this one, you'd say, well, the reaction with silver nitrate doesn't give any indication that a change in composition occurred. And ultimately, then, you would conclude in table 4.11 that solution formation was a physical process, because there's no indication of change here with this test, no indication of change in composition with this test. Well, that's sort of the process that you'll use. Let's pretend now in another part of the experiment, say that you got yes and yes for these two blanks. In other words, you compared a before and after, and they look different to you. They gave a different test result. You'd say, well, yes, it indicates a change in composition. If you had two yeses, you'd say, well, hey, the process must have been a chemical change. What if you had a no and a yes, or a no and a yes this way? Wouldn't matter. Either way, as long as, and you could even have several more tests down here. As long as one of these tests indicated a change in composition, you'd have to conclude that it was a chemical change.